YouTube! How you guys doing today? Mike?
This is Jenny.
Pratt Family Homestead. Hey, we're going to try a little vlogging today. Or the vlog, whatever we want to call it. We got lots of stuff today. We're going to throw taps in a tree. We got to go buy some hay because we ran out. We've covered all that before. So, yeah, we're just going to tap trees, work on the boy goat barn, go buy hay, and probably just kind of stay a little busy.
Always busy.
Right now, we're on the way out the door to go get the hay. Run back and tap trees because apparently it's flowing like crazy right now.
We are
behind as usual. All right, let's go check it all out.
We call our big tree. Yes, we name our trees. And first tap of the season going in. And it's already flowing like crazy.
I'll go get a hammer, but just doing this right now. Watch, we'll see how long that takes. That's dripping. There's about 5 drips in every single one of this. This tree's produced good for us every year. I'm drilling in 2 to 4 inches. I think it's supposed to be 3 to 4. This is what we're using for our taps. Very inexpensive. I don't remember how much these were. Less than $1, I believe.
Bought every single one of them at the store.
I did. Oh, this one's flowing like crazy too. You see it, babe?
Maybe if I actually come over here.
It's already dripping all the way. You can see the drips real good here. It's running like crazy. Guess what else we don't have, Jenny? Firewood.
Oh my gosh. We're so unprepared. This is how we roll. We're last minute people.
That is flowing like crazy. Awesome.
You'll have some sugar.
Hey, this tap, this hole here is actually, I believe, 2 years ago.
I agree. See it running? Watch. See it?
Yeah.
Isn't that cool?
Why is it 2?
Because we put 2 taps in this tree. There's 2 over there, too.
Why is there 5 on this one, but not that one?
Because I haven't gotten there yet.
I can hear it over there. Don't.
Do you need a longer one to put kind of like in that middle area?
No, I think if it builds up, and we'll keep an eye on it, and I got it dripping out here. If we keep an eye on it, I think it'll build up enough.
But it'll flow down.
All right, my awesome. Now the reason we do this out here at this tree, and I want to one year do it all over this whole line of trees, is the 5 gallon buckets are easy to handle up by the house, but as you can see, we're a little farther away, a little more of a pain in the butt to come out here every day in 55 gallon buckets. But if none of this ends up working good, I'm doing 5 gallon buckets. I kind of fought this last year.
Yeah, last year was a little bit of a hassle.
And I'm putting, and that is also causing these taps to be a little higher than I want. But.
Well, it's kind of hard to pick up the camera and vlog when you're messing with such a big guy. But CJ has developed a little bit of thrush in one of his hooves, so Mike helped me. Mike held him while I cleaned it out and got it packed and taken care of. The farrier and I came up with a game plan of how to go ahead and combat it, and we've just had so much wet weather, and as you can kind of see, it's drying out a little bit, but it's just been a mess, wet and muddy. So we got that taken care of, and then CJ and I went for a short walk. Get him out of his pasture, out of the mud, kind of walking and moving a little bit, get on some different surfaces. It's good for him. And now, obviously, he's enjoying his afternoon hay. I gave him a good brush out. He seems to really enjoy rolling in the mud. So he has been incredibly gross for quite some time. So gave him a good brushing, and now he's just going to enjoy the rest of his hay. And I'm going to carry on doing other stuff, although I'm pretty sure I could stand there and just keep brushing him.
Let it go.
Alright guys, now that hunting season is nowhere near us, we get tons of deer. I don't know if Jenny will be able to zoom in to see that. Tons of deer come by. They will not end up on my property though, on our property. All right, come on, let's show them off. Look at that. That 5 gallon bucket is
well over half.
Well over half full. And that, hey Jenny, how long has this been tapped? It's about 6 now. Come up on 6:30.
Well, we tapped.
It hasn't even been 6 hours.
Nope, not even 6 hours.
So that is probably 2.5 gallons in 6 hours. This one still has a good amount, but it's not. It's not.
That one has guilt.
Show me, Grace. Show me.
Can you open that up? Show Mom. That's a puny
amount.
Yeah. Well, actually, to me, that's still a lot, but it's nothing compared to what these other ones are. Grace, Garland, we're over here.
Not very heavy.
Yeah, we're not going to open this one. You can tell us there's not very much in it.
Yeah.
Oh, yep.
That one's pretty full. That one's it got out!
Come here, Muscles.
Cool.
That very first bucket still has the most. Watch out, watch your fingers. There's a good amount in here. There's not. I'd say there's at least the same as that first bucket we checked.
Okay.
But not like double. So that one tree is running fantastic. The others are doing pretty good. This seems to be pretty good too, so.
Yeah.
I'm up here playing Queen of the Mountain.
All this hay for a horse.
That's right. For that guy over there, who you can barely see because it's dark in here.
Okay, so these bales are each of these 18 pack of bales are baled together. So watch out, babe. I'm gonna cut it.
Jenny gonna fall.
Okay.
They're loose.
And then
get to work.
Yeah, I know, right? For your horse.
That's right. Thanks, babe.
Burning. Woo! I made it. And it didn't knock anything down.
You made it!
Woohoo! I made it!
Mom, are you done yet?
No. Hey, Bill.
Thirty four to go. Come on.
Be first.
Yeah, you have flip flops on, so you might get some pokes. Good job. Hey, you want to get over there so somebody else can come up? Oh, lost flip flop.
I lost the other one. Is it gonna fall?
Okay, you do it like the other kid. There you go. Now you jump real big. Jump. Whoa, that's big jump. All right. It's not gonna fall. I stacked it. How could it go wrong?
It could go sideways.
Hey, why don't you go over there? Oh. Grace, follow Andrew. What are you guys doing up there?
Trying not to fall.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Night's winding down. I don't think this has been a super exciting vlog or anything, babe, but just kind of some stuff we're doing today. Didn't get to everything that we wanted to do today. Now we gotta shut down the animals. One of the first things we gotta do is get these chickens off of here. This drives me crazy.
Clear the chickens.
Come on, guys, get out of here. Come on, get out of here.
You missed one.
Oh, yeah. Come on, darling. Okay. All right, goats, come on. The only reason we lock up the goats is because it's a lot easier to take care of everybody else. And then we let the goats go back out at night. Go on.
Go on, Dan.
We currently are not milking. That's going to change this coming week.
Oh, hey, I should have checked for eggs. Yep, there's eggs.
Egg in there?
Two. Jingle, go and take them out.
Oh, yeah.
Put them in my basket. Don't break them.
Oh. Oh.
What are you doing?
This is the, I don't know how well you can see it, hay manger I put together. We dropped hay from up here. Upstairs we got a round bale. We fill this up and the goats eat out of here. We'll see it better in the feed stall. We got our chickens out of here again. Alright.
Hi, Doc.
Since we're not feeding or watering the chickens in the coop anymore, we do throw them a little scratch at night to convince them to get their booties in there. I got some, guys.
Oh, yeah. Come on. Come on.
I take back not feeding them in the coop. We feed them first thing in the morning and then they come out. We feed them in the coop first thing in the morning.
Crazy bird.
Jenny, you want to show them your little egg hunt?
Please, we close the coop door.
Well, while Jenny's in there doing the egg hunt, I'll be over here giving the goats a little bit of grain.
Ooh. Ducky. Excuse me. Excuse me. Another ducky egg.
really do supplemental lighting, but I guess you could technically call it supplemental lighting for the chickens. We have the timer come on for an hour or so in the morning and an hour or so at night, and that's basically so we have a little light coming down here.
Yeah, that's our time frame to do chores so it's not so dark in here.
But we dropped the hay down from this chute right here. Falls onto here. This is version 1.0. It needs a little work. I whipped it together last week real quick. Yeah, you can see right here.
Door.
I think I need to make this a little steeper, so I'm probably actually going to move all this, maybe this way. But that's that.
Did you feed the goats?
And I did feed the goats, and I've already unlocked the goats. And what you might notice walking through here, what we had before, some past videos, you might have saw a fence right here. Well, we have gotten rid of the sheep, Jenny's beloved sheep, and now the goats pretty much have this whole area. We're going to be doing some rearranging here soon, so we hope to take you along on that journey. But Jenny found a really good home for her sheep, and she might even paste in a video of them at their new place here, maybe.
Yeah, maybe got a video from this morning. So.
Yeah, got a video the first day, and the other morning, Jenny's been in contact with the lady, and looks like they got a nice home. So they just weren't the right fit for what we're trying to do. So, all right. Baby, let's try something.
It don't work.
Oh, we're blind.
Say goodnight, baby.
Goodnight.
Goodnight. I'm Mike.
I'm Jenny.
Pratt Family Homestead. No idea if we're in frame.
We're somewhere in here.
We're somewhere.
You're going to make somebody dizzy.
All right, guys. Have a good night.